So you're looking to have your face painted today? You are? Okay. Did you have any specific, ideas of what you wanted your face to look like? Just some designs? Yeah, we can do that. We can, play it by ear and, see what we end up with. The first thing that we have to do, of course, is, clean your face. We're just going to be using a light water-based wipe to clean your face from any debris. Okay. Now this is cold and it's going to feel cool on your skin. That's just because of the water, of course. Okay, so just so you're ready, I'm just going to get your cheeks on both sides, and I'm going to have to go over your eyes, so just so you know, just over your eyelids. Under your chin, on the side of your neck, and on this side as well. Going to actually move your hair a little bit just so I can reach your forehead. There we go. Okay. So, the second thing that we're going to do is just put a base on your whole face, and this will help the paint adhere to your skin. So this is basically just a primer for the paint itself. Just going to apply on this side of it. And on this side as well. On your chin, and on this side. Going to need to move your hair a little bit again, just so I can reach your forehead. Should be good. So do you know what designs you want now? Nothing specific? The first thing we could do, if you want, is put a type of kind of a wave on both sides of your cheek. So it'd be something like that, or maybe like this would make more sense. So you might start here and then come down and wrap around both sides of your mouth. And then if you wanted, we could then work around that. Okay? Do you want to try that? Okay. And did you have any colors in mind? You want to work with blues? Okay. would recommend a darker blue, only because those are more pronounced and they tend to last a little bit longer. Maybe something like this. Is that fine with you? Yeah? Okay. So we can just use some of that. And I'm going to be switching with brushes. So this one's a little bit finer, and we're just going to use that to get the initial outline of this swirl, okay? Just like that. Wrap around. Is this for a party, or are you preparing for the Halloween season? Halloween? Okay. Yeah, I know. I know a few people who like to try to get a head start on it. If we can do that. I'm going to be grabbing another brush now to actually fill in that color. Just if we can. If you don't mind, I'm going to need to hold your skin to keep it firm as I do this. Okay. Thanks for staying so still. On this side. Looks pretty good. We do just so right now you just have that blue line on both sides running through like that, so it runs through like starting at the center of your ear, coming down and then straight under. To work around that, we might, if you want, we can put some circles surrounding that closer to the chin. And then we can vary between one or two or three colors. Do you want to try that? Yeah. Okay. So we have blue. I would suggest going with maybe something a little bit lighter. Are you partial to reds at all? You like reds? Okay. What about alternating between a red like this and then maybe a dark pink? Try that. Okay. Use this brush again. I'm actually going to get a little bit closer this time, just so I can get the details in there. Just just want to make sure that all of those circles are precise. On both sides as well. You know, wipe your face again really fast. It's just some dust on it. Just quickly. There we go. So, I'm going to need to get a little bit closer for this. Just to get all of those details in there. So I'm going to need to get a little bit closer just to get all of those details in there. Put that down. So, is this face going to a specific costume, or are you hoping to get an idea of the costume from the face itself? Yeah, I am. I mean, obviously, obviously everyone's different, but I have a tendency of waiting to the last minute as well. Then a bit more. Obviously everyone's different, but so that's done. You have the two lines with the circular structure surrounding that on the inner chin. I have it kind of in a diamond pattern. So right now you have the lines, and then there's kind of a diamond shaped through the circles. I'm thinking that for your nose, we could just kind of do like a general brush strokes outward with varying colors. And that could work up to your eyes, and then we could start doing some more designs there. What do you think about that? You like it? Okay. So the first color that I was thinking was maybe do. I feel like we should stay within the same general color scheme that we've already started on. So maybe a lighter variation of blue, and then any colors that we use when we get to your eyes can be darker so that we can draw attention to that area. Do you wanna do something like that? Yeah. Okay. So just pick a color. I I would have picked that myself, so good choice. Just going to put that on. Then starting at your nose, right next to your eye. Do you get your face painted every year, or is this the first time? Every year. Okay. No, I normally do not get my face painted, only because, you know, it's like I spend all day painting faces. By the end of the day, I'm kind of tired of it. It's like the chef who doesn't cook when he gets home, right? So, but I'm more than happy to paint other people's faces. We have we have the blue. If you want, we can start lightening it up as we spread out, and then once it hits your eyes, we'll get darker. So with the blue, after that, do you want to? Well, what color were you thinking for the eyes? A red. Okay. Do you want to work into that color then? Maybe go for a, let's see. Do you want maybe go for a turquoise, and then after that we can hit the red? Yeah. Okay, that's fine. And just do like that. And just go here, do the same with that. Okay, so I'm going to use a third brush now, with a little bit of water, and this is just going to help kind of brush those two colors together. It's going to be very lightly wet, because too much and it's just going to start running, so we just want to bring that together, okay? Then we got that. We can mix. There we go. Get on this side. Now for the eyes. You said you wanted a red, is that right? A red? Okay. Well, like I said earlier, we want to really highlight those eyes, especially ones like yours. So we'll do the red, and we could probably just circle. So right now, the color is coming upward, going like that. For the red, we can actually just go straight over your eyelids, and then it'll bleed out from there with a more direct line. Do you want to try that? Yeah, OK. So we're going to use a blood red for this. And if you can close this eye here, and I'm going to need to get close because I want to make sure that I keep within the frame of your eyelid, okay? So just gonna go slowly with this one. Just like that. Okay. And we can get there. I'm going to go on to the other side now. Just in a moment, I'm going to have to grab another brush so that we can get those defined lines coming off from your eyelids, okay? For now, this should be fine. That looks great. The final thing is I'm going to use a very small brush, so you can see how small that is, and we're going to create that dark line to define the colors a little better, or the separation of colors. We're just going to use black for that actually. Just there. I'm going to have to get close for this as well. Thank you for being so still and patient. Sorry. Oh, the left hand. Yeah. Well, after painting for so long, you learn to become somewhat ambidextrous, and a lot of people were able to use both hands to some extent after painting for a while. That might not be true. That's what happened to me at least, but it might not happen to everyone. Just going to end. That looks pretty good. Pretty good. For the forehead, do you want to just end it with a golden powder? You do? Okay. So we can use some a shinier paint for that. It's actually more of a cream even. Just start at the top with that, and we can go there. And start at the top again. On that side. Right. Well, if face looks amazing now, and I think it will help you decide what you want to do for Halloween. And if it doesn't, then at least you have a very cool painted face. Do you want any final details put in before you leave? No? Okay, in that case, I hope you enjoy your upcoming Halloween, and I hope that this inspires you in deciding what to wear as a costume. Okay, I'll see you later.